two-way analysis of variance in SPSS. If you want to know the effect of a categorical variable on a numeric variable, we use a t-test or analysis of variance. For example, if you want to know whether the celebrity endorsing a campaign is relevant to a respondent's willingness to donate, then we use a one-way analysis of variance. But what if the effect of celebrity on willingness to donate differs between males and females? In that case, we have to do a two-way analysis of variance, using two categorical variables as predictors or factors. In SPSS, two-way analysis of variance is a general linear model, and we need the univariate command. The numeric variable must be selected as the dependent variable, its willingness to donate in our example, and the categorical variables are selected as fixed factors. Now, in addition, it's very helpful to have a means plot of the interaction effect. Under plots, we can select the predictor endorser on the horizontal axis, and we use the moderator to obtain separate lines. Press the Add button, and then we will get a means plot later on. Endorser is a categorical variable with more than two categories, so we may want to apply post hoc tests with the Bonferroni correction to see in the end where the differences are. And finally, under options, it's very helpful to select descriptive statistics, and we must also select the homogeneity test to see whether we meet the requirements for analysis of variance. Okay, that's it. Let's paste and run. The descriptive statistics give us the means and standard deviations for all groups and subgroups, and we can use this table to check whether all groups and subgroups are of equal size. In this example, every combination of a celebrity and a sex should contain about the same number of observations. In this table, we see that the number of observations ranges from 22 for males who are not confronted to a celebrity endorser, to about 25 for females seeing George Clooney or males seeing Angelina Jolie. So the difference between the largest group and the smallest group is 3 subjects, and that's just slightly more than the 10% of the size of the largest group that we would accept to meet the requirement of equal group sizes. So we may not meet the requirements here. But the alternative requirement is that the population variances of the groups are equal. Levine's test on the equality of population variances in this case has a p-value of 0.83, which is well above 0.05, so we cannot reject the null hypothesis that the subgroups have equal population variances. We do meet the requirements for an analysis of variance. Now, let's go to the main table with results, tests of between subjects effects. There are 3 effects that are important to us: the main effect of endorser, the main effect of sex, and the interaction effect of endorser and sex. All 3 effects have an F-test, an F-value with an associated p-value, and all 3 p-values here are below 0.05. For the 2 main effects and the interaction effect, we can reject the null hypothesis that there is no effect in the population. There are differences in willingness to donate depending on the endorser, depending on sex and the interaction. How do we interpret these effects? For the main effects, we can have a look at the descriptive statistics. We see that females, on average, are more willing to donate than males. That is the interpretation of the main effect of sex. For the endorser, the situation is a bit more complicated because we have more than 2 groups. In this case, we can have a look at the post hoc tests. And there we see that if we compare a campaign without a celebrity endorser, so with nobody, and a campaign with Clooney or Jolie as endorser, there is a statistically significant difference in average willingness to donate. Respondents confronted with George Clooney or Angelina Jolie on average have about 1 point more willingness to donate. Finally, let's have a look at the interaction effect. And here, the best thing is to have a look at the means plot. The blue line represents the male respondents and the green line represents the female respondents. As we can see, if there is no celebrity endorser, females are on average more willing to donate than men. But then, if we have a look at George Clooney as endorser, we see that the difference between females and males is much larger. Females confronted with George Clooney as an endorser are much more willing to donate than men. And finally, for Angelina Jolie, we don't see a difference between males and females at all. They more or less have the same willingness to donate. So the difference between males and females with respect to their willingness to donate is different for different endorsers. Different differences, that is moderation.